Hi, the DUUX Global Table Fan. This is it. It is like a walled globe, but they've taken the world away. They've took the front off and they've put a fan inside of it. It's a good solid black plastic unit, 2.5 kilos, will sit on a bedside table, a work desk, wherever you want it really, in your kitchen, wherever. It's not going to cause much of a problem, and I think it looks pretty trendy as well. The cable power supply does unplug from the unit like so. So if you are going to put it on a cabinet or something, you haven't got to worry about trying to feed a 3-pin socket through the back. You can just feed that up through. As long as there's a small gap, you'll be able to plug it in without moving everything around. When it's plugged in, you will have a little red LED on the front there, just to say that it's got power. And to start off with, just press and hold that for a couple of seconds, and it's all powered up. Each time you then press your power button, you will increase and decrease the speed of the fan. Nice and clear on these LEDs, which speed that you're on. These LEDs will dim down after about 10 seconds. They'll dim down a bit just so at night time you don't find it too irritating. And then to wake it back up, you just have to press any of the buttons again, and they'll light back up, and then the switches will start doing their stuff. I'm going to keep the fan low because we've done one take of this already, and every time the fan came to point at the camera, it was making the sound distort because the air was blowing the microphone too much. So we're going to keep that on low. So 3 speed settings, and then also on this one you can set it to run for 1 hour or 3 hours or continuously. So quite useful if you like a fan on at night to go to sleep, but you don't necessarily want it running for the whole evening. You can set it for the 1 hour, for 3 hours, just to keep you nice and cool at night till you got yourself off to sleep, and then it will just switch itself off. These are the switches here. Yes, you do have your normal left and right movement. It's an 80 degree angle, so if you were in the corner of a, if you put that in the corner of a room, it will pretty much go from the left hand wall over to the right hand wall. Pretty traditional, as you will find with most sort of desktops or stand fans, that you'd have this oscillating movement. But what is also quite impressive with it is you can press this button here, and then it will also start going up and down. So you've got 90 degrees of movement on that, going from facing you directly right up to pretty much facing the ceiling. You can have it left and right movement, up and down movement, or you can have it doing the whole lot. So really useful if you're trying to cool a whole room. But also I think the up and down movement I quite like, because normally when it's going left and right, if you want it to just really be pointing it at you, which you might well want if it's in a bedroom or something, you don't necessarily want the air pointing at you all the time. But when you've got that left and right movement, it's only on you for a few seconds of each full movement. Whereas with the up and down, you can get it so that it's basically sort of staying on you, but will move around the body to help you keep cool. So I really like that feature. It is quite a strong fan. If I stop that moving, just so it's not pointing at the camera, and we rack up the speed to full. So that's on 3. Grab a bit of paper. I mean, it's not probably the best way of showing you how strong the fan is, but that is, bearing in mind that's pointing up in the air, but that is still hitting that paper, you know, quite a way away from it. So you will feel the breeze, I think, pretty well for what's actually quite a small fan. It does seem quite powerful. I can't really think of any major downsides to it. Let's just turn that back down. Black plastic, maybe. Once you've got a bit of static is built up on it, and after a good few weeks or months worth of use, I don't doubt that's going to attract the dust, particularly on these little swirls. You're going to get some dust in there, but you will on any caged type fan. Those will get quite grubby after a while. All it needs is a damp cloth, and you can wipe it over, and that will keep it nice and clean. The one trick that I haven't shown you yet is it does come with a remote control. So if it is by your bed, if it's in the corner of a room, if it's a little way away from you on your desk, you don't have to keep reaching over to change everything. It's all on there. You can switch it on and off. You can change the speed of the fan up and down. You can set your timer, and you can set whether you want it to go left, right, up, down, or just stay in static. So that's a really nice feature. The only other problem I have with it, I mean, it is fairly straightforward to use. The buttons take a little bit of getting used to. When the LEDs die down and you've just got to tap it again, sometimes you do find you're pressing the buttons a few times to get it working properly. I think that's probably more just getting used to how it works than anything else. But the other thing was, on the instructions, it's got one of those barcodes that you scan that's supposed to take you to an instructional video. When I tried it, it did this. Basically, it just it didn't work. But not the end of the world. It's not the most complicated piece of kit. And I'm sure they'll maybe sort that out in due course. But really, those are the only couple of, if you were looking for it, negatives. Otherwise, I think it's a good, sturdy, trendy looking, cool, pardon the pun, cool unit. Thanks for watching the DUUX Global Table Fan.